These beats are the purest. Prove it, prove it.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the second week of the playoffs. I believe this is the first match of the... I think technically this is the first match of the playoffs because the other ones were play-ins, I believe.
Technically, yeah.
This is between the Charlemagne Shapeshifters and the Broncos Country Riders. I'm Panini. I'm here with Mr. Riddle Dog.
Hello, hello.
So, what are you expecting coming into this game?
I'm not sure. I mean, the Shapeshifters are looking to... take the win as the 7th seed taking down the number 10 seed of the Broncos Country Riders. But the first time in a long time where the Broncos Country Riders has their full roster as well.
Yeah, and the Shapeshifters are also not at a full roster because they are down Frosty with Muffin Lumps ringing. But yeah, Flawless was one of the... I think it was a first-round pick, and...
He
hasn't been able to show up. Yeah, he was rolled by the Jimmies and then traded. But yeah, Flawless hasn't been able to show up, but he's here today. Personally, I'm expecting that to be a huge impact. I know some of the ringers they've had have been doing pretty good. But, I mean, just Flawless is back playing for the team. I think that's going to be a really important piece for them today.
Yeah, commonly, Booney would have Corey... go into Flawless's spot as well, but
yeah, this does also open it up because Flawless has been playing a lot of DPS. I believe he's been playing a lot of BAPs specifically, and I think Corey would not be allowed to do that when he was ringing, so this does also open up some more flexibility within the Riders' roster when they make these like subs and rotations with their lineup.
Completely. You will see as well that Flawless is going to be on support from map one as well.
Yes, Flawless and Transflect are both very capable on both support and DPS. So that they might swap back and forth throughout the map, but we are swapping with this Flawless support. First map is Legion Tower, I believe.
It is the shapeshifter's choice.
Have they picked yet, or is this the fall?
I asked if what the map choice was, and then he never responded. And now he just said, "Oh yeah, I can pick that."
Oh, okay. So, yeah, because I thought I missed something, and he was just picking that. But yeah, I'm thinking. I wonder if the Riders are going to swap their lineup based on them. Oh, they looks like they do. Yeah, so they are swapping Flawless back on a DPS and Transflect Black back on a support. I would think that now that they put Flambeau in for HV, that means they're either going to run a Mercy Pocket or run a Lucio, because those have been like two of Flambeau's most played characters this season. Especially on a Koth map, I would probably expect like a Lucio Brawl coming out from them, and then you also have like on the other side Muffin Lumps, I think, with Rusty Goomba. I think that would also be like a pretty good, they could run a pretty good brawl with that.
Yeah, completely.
Oh.
Yeah, Rusty Goomba on the shapeshifters is going to be running Busan.
Busan, he finally gave you a map pick. So, well, we'll see if they have swaps after they know that it's Busan.
Yep.
They might opt to go back.
So we are going to be starting off on.
I guess they're running with this.
Time Busan. Yep.
First map here, downtown. Usually you have either a Widow. Probably would run both the Widow and the like a Winston or some sort of dive. And with Invictus, we know he's like very capable on long range hit scan DPS characters. So he's who I'm keeping an eye on this first point here.
Yeah, you will see immediately an Ashe pick out from him.
Yeah.
It's like his comfortable hero as well, so we'll have to see if he decides to keep on this. As Rusty Goomba wants to tease the Doomfist.
I would not hate a Doomfist, actually. Boonie's hovering the D.Va, and I think that makes sense. That fits a lot better into Boonie's hero pool. But also, like, it's again, it's one of those characters that can access the high grounds really easily and move in. Slime Ball and a Sombra. Slybo's been playing a lot of Sombra this season. I think that might get a lot of value against this D.Va here, especially if he gets too aggressive.
And it will be rolling out with that pocket Invictus strategy with Slimbo on that Mercy pocket. It's Rusty Goomba takes an early engage, but Pneumonia with a crazy headshot across the map onto Invictus. Being distracted by Rambo.
Are getting pushed here.
They kind Pneumonia of is still here, in. He gets another as well. He falls deathly low, but Flawless is able to pick him off after trying to find out where he is.
Yeah, hitscan is really good in like a sniper duel, like running this Ashe, but it is really difficult to run it into like a five-man dive. They're pretty much going to be looking for either Flambeau or Invictus, try to just catch them out, and they should be pretty easy to collapse on here.
Yeah, an early hack comes out, but Transflect, worried that the rest of the cavalry is going to come in for the shapeshifters, gets an early Suzo off to on Flambeau just to save him. Nothing really happens from that, though.
Boonie is creating a lot of space here. Flambeau is able to keep Invictus alive. And it is pretty even right now.
Yeah, Goku does use the Pulse Bomb, not able to land it on him. We get a melee punch into Transflect. Someone picking up Boonie as just clean up now.
It is really interesting that they swap Flawless onto this Tracer, because that's another character Invictus is capable on. It is going to be very difficult to run this hitscan when he's getting dove this hard by the shapeshifters. I wonder if he's going to commit to it. He is rolling the Cassidy, which I think is a little bit better than the Ashe, but it is another one that is pretty easy to collapse on.
Yeah, both support ults coming online for the side of the Cruncher Riders as well. Flambeau either just still wanting to pocket Invictus. A nice punch, but a nice Suzu as well.
Rusty gets two.
Often gets stuck. Riley does get two, but I can't believe
Flambeau goes for the
resin
and canceled. Yeah, this is looking very rough for the Riders right now. Slimeball has this EMP. They also have Beat and Kitsune Rush. This is going to be really difficult to push into. And it likely is going to be last fight if the Broncos Country Riders do lose here. Hopefully Transflex can get a lot of value with this Kitsune Rush, especially if he uses it at first, but that's pretty much all they have to work with here.
They did get an early pick on Dooku as well, and Victus able to land those shots. Is expecting nothing less, but nice EMP comes out on the four members. Ammonia able to find Flawless early.
Consider Rush got canceled from Transflex.
Oh no.
And Booney is trying his best, but I don't think it's gonna be enough.
I don't think
he's
so.
He's fighting the good fight, but loses the 1v5. And that's probably gonna be curtains for downtown.
The Tickle Monster strat yeah. from the Shapeshifters. They wouldn't expect it.
It is really difficult to play into that dive comp unless you're like committing to either going like full counter dive or just going like really undiveable characters. They were kind of trying to do like a couple of different, they had a couple different ideas going on with their comp. So I think it would have been better if they just committed to one against the hard dive that the shapeshifters are running. And then here is I think this is a much better comp, at least for the going into the Doomfist is the like kind of a brawl.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a lot harder for the Doomfist to like go super aggro and find value against the Brawl. They should be pretty sustainable here.
Yeah, they're gonna keep this Doomfist though, as it's looking like sort of a poke style comp with the two DPS, but Rusty Goomba and Muffin trying to hold the front line back as it's just this huge brawl comp. Able to get the empowered punch and just push everyone back. As the Glunku gets a concussion line on the Flawless. Booney does kick his over onto Muffin though, but another nice punch by Rusty Goomba takes down Invictus as the rest of the Country Riders are just trying to walk on Goku, but with Pneumonia's support, just impossible to keep him up.
Yeah, their Riders comp provides a little bit more beef, but with the Doomfist, if he charges and power punches, he is just going to farm his team. He's already gotten his ult after the first fight. It is Doomfist, he does build it pretty quickly, but he's just basically getting a power punch and then punching into the team.
All comes out from Invictus, but it's not able to find anything as Rusty Goomba able to get like 20% of his ult.
Yeah.
And then he just slams down onto the support line.
They are trying to look for the wall here. I think that's pretty much going to have to be their win condition is wall off Rusty Goomba and find some way to kill him, but they don't have the
you
burst
see,
damage
you see Goku?
To take it down.
He's behind them in their spawn. The wall
gets one.
It's not able to stop the tire. Flawless finds him. The Zuzu out from Ammonia saves him from the sticky mine. The sticky grenade.
Booney's close to shatter.
The Zuzu. Booney's just surrounded.
Solo.
Slimeball gets a nice headshot on the Flawless.
Yeah, I think they just need to reset and spawn here.
Flambo. Oh, they're able to get out. Rusty's just poking the Hornet's Nest right now.
Shatter gets the one he did. Suzu!
The Suzu from Pneumonia. Comes out again.
Oh,
the
beef
from Flambo. Able to find Booney and Flawless. As Invictus, you see moving over to Hanzo. Not able to land any shots on Pneumonia.
It doesn't matter because Goku's on Chunkrat.
The Glunku.
The Glunku.
He's got another tire too.
The Broncos are going to be able to touch, but they have Conceited Rush, but Goku has this tire that
do they
could
know?
Be all they need.
Invictus knows.
Does he know? Invictus knows. He knows.
Knows. Body shot comes out.
Flawless gets one. They don't touch.
They just don't touch
no
on
way.
Top. They're so worried that they're trying to protect that High Noon.
Yeah.
And everything.
So 200 to 2 Busan. Hopefully, Broncos are going to go to the well and try to write a new strat coming into this. Because they're going to have to figure something out. Yeah, very good from the Shapeshifters. They looked really clean. They were playing a lot of very good comps. And Riders just didn't have an answer for it.
Yeah. Very well played. That Doomfist did wonders. As well against the Riders, just putting pressure so in so many different angles like that. He's in your back line with the Glunku as well. Slimeball's up front with the Hanzo pick. It's rough.
Also, we got to see a little bit of Invictus May. We don't see that very often.
We did. That was fun.
I think also part of what is rough is that Invictus and Flawless do have a lot of the same characters played. They both really like the Tracer and like the Cassidy.
Mm-hmm.
So in the brawl, we saw Flawless go to the Cassidy and Invictus just had to play the Mei.
Yeah.
Some big swaps coming out from both teams. We do have Zainu Baba coming in from Rusty Goomba.
Yep, Zainu Baba going to be over onto the tank for the shapeshifters, yeah, with Rusty Goomba riding the bench this second.
Going into hybrid, I do expect them to run Zainu Baba on Rein. I know it's one of his better tanks. They have been doing this. I think Rusty wants to get Zainu Baba playtime because their roster, I feel like everyone pretty much deserves playtime on the shapeshifters. So Rusty always likes to get Zainu Baba some playtime whenever he can.
Mm-hmm.
And then on the rider side, we have Flawless coming in for Flambo Jambo, and we have HB Set coming in from Flambo Jambo, and we have Flawless swapping over to support, and then for Flawless coming off of DPS, we have Wabakon coming in. Wabakon's been playing a lot of, I believe his main ones are Bastion, Torb, and Junkrat.
Yep.
So the Fedora Master special.
Yeah, like Fedora Master, your Nort Logic.
Yeah.
As well. Yeah, the Boonie and the writers are going to be picking Hollywood as well. And it is important to note that it is now back to best of five. The play-ins were just first two.
Yes.
As well as this.
So one team is going to have to win.
Yep.
I guess they could technically win two, but they have to win three, I believe.
Yeah.
If they draw on hybrid. Yeah, I guess it wouldn't be best of five. Because if there's a drawn hybrid and then it's a 2-2 split, then they have to play another one.
It's mainly just
First to three. Yeah.
I can think of it like best of five as well. This is the map where the Jimmies were taken down. The playoffs run was denied from them by the Paris Paper Planes.
We did still get the Jimmy sweep.
We did. You're not entirely wrong.
Boonie shows the Zarya here. Well, I guess they are in the spawn. If we do this right... I know Zarya is one of Boonie's better tanks.
Mm-hmm. Playing it a lot this season as well as on his other team.
Okay.
Lil Drippers.
Lil Drippers.
As well. Yep. The
shapeshifters are coming out with a Sigma Zen with Goku on Hanzo and Slimeball on the soldier. I think that if the riders do tend to go for this brawl, they could try to punish Zainu Baba here. If they try to take the fights really quickly, they might be able to run him over.
Definitely. It will be hard for the riders as well, though, because of all the angles that the rest of the team has set up.
Goku.
Yeah, Goku with Muffin over in Cafe as well. But we'll have to see if the Redders are up for the task. The Redders do decide to try to walk up onto the high ground, able to force Zainu Baba down as well, though, taking space, as Goku's just spamming from Cafe. Slimeball, you will see him going over onto the flank here, trying to find HVSIC. He's got his eyes on him. Boonie in the front line.
Boonie's got him right where he wants him. A cluster in Cafe, and he just presses W and runs over the team.
Yeah, Slimeball not able to secure the pick onto HV as Invictus turns to help, able to be taking him down as well. As not enough pressure from a lot of the shapeshifters there to just stop the riders from donk walking in.
Yeah. Really good pathing for Boonie to just get that space, and then once he got the space, they all just got basically forced into a corner, and he can just hold M1. We do have Goku's coming close to this dragon, but also 72% for Boonie on this Grav.
Yeah, he's done so much so far as well, as HVSec is farming that nano as well. Flawless able to take down Slimeball.
Oh, HV has a nano too. They could opt to nano Boonie here, just have him get grab even faster. They're not even gonna need it here. Booty gets two.
He's just walking on the rest of them. He does leave Flawless, but
Wobbuffet. They're gonna be able to get Zainu Baba kind of late there. Yeah, the Streets phase and a lot of these escort maps are really prone to snowballing, so they might be able to keep this momentum, especially if they play really aggressive here. They might be able to turn this into a second point. Invictus finds Goku.
Oh, Invictus. A nice shot. He does notice Slimeball is trying to flank behind him as well, though. He's just waiting patiently.
There's going to be a lot of ults here. I think it's basically going to come down to who ults first. If they manage to get like a big grab here or a big flux, that might be all they need in the fight.
Yeah, it's just early poke. Nothing much going on.
Also, the support ults are way ahead in the Rider's favor.
Yeah, despite that, though. Someone is able to find HP in this early poke phase. Flawless, the savior for Boonie, able to use the flux, finds Wobbuffet, but he's just trying to turn on Boonie as he's just walking on the rest of his team. Anna comes out from Pneumonia, and he takes down Wobbuffet with this extra power.
That was a big nano coming out from Pneumonia there. I think if they don't get the nano off, I'm pretty sure Wobbuffet would have killed Zainu Baba, and that might have been it for the fight.
I think so.
Keeps him alive, and he gets the kill onto Wobbuffet. Well, he gets Slime Ball again.
Yeah, Slime Ball not able to land anything. Interesting, Suzu. Perfectly timed as well.
Yeah. Goku finds Flawless. The nano and the Blossom here.
Eats the shot from Goku. As well as
Rumpus takes probably need to force this trance here before they're able to actually push in, because Muffin Lumps is holding into the back pocket, and that is going to be tough to push into.
Yeah, definitely. Wobbuffet is.
That must have been a bad finger.
His team.
I don't think he meant to Death Blossom there.
I assume not. A dragon comes out from Goku, which forced the sightline from HV. He can't see Boonie to heal him, really. Flawless.
The nano comes up.
The nano Zainu's comes out low. Just to save him. There's the trance you're worried about. Is this just.
I mean, tricky nano for beating. Trance, that's actually kind of good for the Riders.
Flawless finds Slime Ball again.
Again.
Yeah. Zainu Baba, he needs to touch. Oh, he doesn't touch.
Muffin gets taken down.
Muffin gets taken down, too.
Yeah, when I, if I were Zainu Baba and I saw Boonie walking in on the Zarya, I would be, with his girthy charge he had, I would be very scared too. No
one can hide. Yeah, I don't blame you. Slime Ball, take it down again.
Zarya has not been hard meta, but she does still do a lot of damage, especially at high charge. So when Boonie's high charge, you gotta respect that.
Yeah.
You also see Grav and Flux coming out here too. Last time, Zainu Baba got caught in the grav and then used the flux and was somehow able to survive through that grav.
Yeah, oh, a nice shout out from Goku as well and Wobbuffet, but Boonie just decided to take the long roads up and walk all the way to the high ground. Seeing Wobbuffet fall right before his eyes.
Invictus is in.
Invictus is able to find Goku and Gravitic Flux comes up from Zainu Baba, not able to finish off Boonie or anything. He just has bubbles, so the rock won't even do anything. Boonie with the 4K.
And they still have Grav. It's going to be like a stagger fight, and Boonie's just going to be able to use Grav for cleanup here.
Yeah.
Oh, Zainu Baba does swap on the Rhyne.
The Rhyne. But a nice Grav.
Gugu there. We got Muffin Lumps too. Nano comes out on Zainu Baba, but it doesn't even matter. They can't touch.
Oh.
After such a dominant first map going into Hollywood, I was not expecting a 2.5 minute time bank on attack.
I wasn't either. It just seems like the Zarya's been working wonders for the Broncos Country Riders as they're just donk walking down main, and the Sigma pick is not it.
I also think this goes to show you sometimes that like the meta doesn't necessarily matter, because I know Boonie is very comfortable in the Zarya, so sometimes just play your comfort picks and just it'll work.
It just goes to show you as well, so I wouldn't be surprised if Boonie decided to keep with that as well as we do see it. With Invictus moving over to the Hanzo. Never mind.
Zainu Baba does go on to the
Ash.
He is hovering the Winston here, which I think is very good, especially if Invictus does run with his Ash. if you're worried about the Zarya just walking on your team, just go over the Zarya and go to the back line. That looks like they're playing here. They're also not running a Mercy Pocket with Invictus, so they might be able to punish Invictus here.
What rat strat is this?
They're in spawn.
2 years old strat? What is this?
They're in spawn, but I will say that if the shapeshifters swap, they are cowards for robbing us of this beautiful comp they want to run.
I don't know. I mean, Goku, they're sticking. I don't know about Muffin.
You're gonna
Uh-oh.
Tower. What's it called? The boost the Bastion up in the air, and he's gonna get the sight lines.
Wait a minute. Are they gonna boost? Are they gonna boost him up and then TP?
I think I've heard Bastion. Some team wanted to run a Bastion Life Weaver comp. Maybe this is what they want to do.
The TP comes out. It's on the point.
There it is.
Up. Slime all fell.
And the Goku does get taken down, but then they get Boonie too.
Nice pull.
The pull of Slime Mole. Oh, but they forgot about Invictus.
Invictus just in a shooting range right now. They're not walking on him. What do you and Zanubaba do
no,
find
No, the shapeshifters are going to win this. They have the spawns too.
Invictus finds his.
He
lands the shot on the Goku! That's all that he needed.
Oh, the Bogey got him! Oh, Booty's back though. It's Jover.
No, wait, the rest of his team's coming back too.
Slimeball's back too! Booty's gotta hold out. You have Wobbacon back, you have HV able to heal from Cafe.
Booty is able to get onto point, but Pneumonia Booty just lands his headshots. The burst from the Kiriko's real. Oh my gosh.
This is just one of the messiest fights I've ever seen.
Yeah.
That was a minute and a half long fight right there.
Very, very,
yeah,
very.
Yeah. I think that's pretty much everything that the shapeshifters wanted to do. There were a couple of unlucky picks coming out, Invictus clicking some headshots, but the Winston is putting in a lot of work, able to put a ton of pressure on the back line, which does set up the rest of the team to get some very good angles out.
Goku is going to be trying to go behind as well. He's just waiting for his team to set up. There he is. He's just aim-checking Invictus and HV right now. Where's Rick Hobbit and Isaac?
The Suzu!
From Flawless.
Flawless is looking rent-free in Goku's head right now.
Yeah.
I guess it was Slime Mole on the attack, actually, so they did swap the Tracer.
Yeah, they did. Goku able to find Invictus in the back line as Flawless is too busy up front. The Katuna Rush from Logan as well as the Hammer Ridge from Zainababa just to make sure he doesn't die and clear this out.
And the Riders are coming up on 5 ults, and shapeshifters did use 3 there. So the Broncos are going to have the ult advantage coming into this. They might have to overcommit just to stabilize here because they are a little bit on the back foot right now.
Yeah, they don't want to blow it all though.
The grab is going to be big, especially if Muffin Lumps doesn't build his trance in time. He's at 89%, now he's 90. If he does build the trance, they should be able to counter that, but...
The Katuna Rush comes out from Flawless early, straight on the point as Invictus decides to throw the mob in just for extra measure. Suzu comes out, but Zainababa isn't able to jump out in time. Bob does find Muffin Lumps.
And I think shapeshifters are going to reset. Yep. It is going to be tough for the Broncos to force the shapeshifters off the high ground. Now that they got Slime Ball, that's going to be a lot easier. Oh yeah, only 2 ults there. The Bob and the Katsuna Rush is...
Who is in? The money decides to commit to TP Suzu.
And they're already back together now. But yeah, only using the Bob and the Katsuna Rush is actually a pretty good economy coming out from the Riders. They do still have this grab along with the Nano and the Blossom. The Trance is out, but if they do use their ultimates, they should be able to force the Trance with 1 ult and then win the fight. But then Invictus
Slime
gets taken by Slime Ball.
Able to take down Invictus. HV's just cowering in fear from this high ground. Nano comes out onto Boonie as well as he's looking to use that grab. A really nice Trance from Muffin Lumps though, just to make sure that Zainababa is kept up through all this madness. He falls super low. But Wobbacon with the 4k Death Blossom! But his team needed it most.
Yeah, I thought for a second there's no way the Riders were going to win that. They did use the remaining 3 ults, but I think you take that if you get to hold on to this point here. They did get the Trance out and the Overclocked out, so it was actually still pretty even in terms of ults there.
Wow. That was a really good special move out from the Reaper guy.
The Reaper guy. With his shotguns, or whatever the... I don't know the exact... Oh, no, he gets snipes Invictus across the map!
Uh-oh. Xenobaba is in, though, as Logan TP's in and uses the Suzu as well as the Kitsune Rush.
Pneumonia gets two.
Who needs pulse, though? So HV's just left on the high ground.
Yeah, but I think at this point for the Riders, the Broncos are just going to play for time here. They're going to have the time advantage, so if they're able to kill off more time, they might be able to at least secure not losing this point. If they're able to for Sochi.
He didn't use the staggered new staggered spawns feature.
That was a bait. He was trying to bait Goku in so Invictus could get the headshot.
Invictus with the question mark. As well. Oh, Zynobaba
does get really low, forced to Primal. Likely just to get out, but...
Yeah. Not many ults, as Flash says he's the only one on the field right now. Force Slimewall out to slide to the rest of his team, Invictus with Night Dynamite to take down Slimewall.
Now Boonie goes in.
The team just gonna donk walk in. The Kiriko duel.
If he staggers Pneumonia here, that might be big.
If Boonie staggers himself, that's gonna be big.
Hey, yeah, the trance is coming out from Pneumonia. They are gonna probably use that for the grab that Boonie's building here soon. If they're able to split up the grab and the nano, I think that's how you force out the trance and then able to win the fight. Last time they stacked them both and they both got countered by the trance. Slimewall is also up close to this overclock. That also could carry the fight here. Zaidu falls really low. I don't think they're able to...
Not much going on. Trance forced by Muffin Lumps before he's even able to send out the grab, but Slimewall takes down Invictus before he can use the bob. Aldous does find Goku. Boonie is going to fall. Wabakon.
Invictus has the bob, so they should be able to at least get the touch in.
Invictus cannot die here. Okay.
They're opting full reset and spawn. A lot of ults are coming out for the Riders, but also the overclock Boonie. And the...
The Ryan. The nano bob. Bob's already taken down with the Discord orb. Flawless takes on Muffin Lumps, but Zynobaba finds HVSec.
Special move in.
The special move, it's time.
Special move.
Oh, Goku!
He jumped on the ball.
He jumps on the bomb. Pneumonia finds his.
He might have the spawns here, actually.
HV's here, and Invictus is to take on Goku. Muffin Lumps tries to touch as well.
Oh, Boonie's back.
But Pneumonia just living in their backline. There's nothing they can do. Zynobaba, he wants to get back to the point. He wants to win this. He's just trying to push them off at this point.
Oh, they're off. Oh, Flawless
is able to get on. Can Boonie live?
Trade tanks, though.
They just need 7 more seconds. Invictus needs to be able
Invictus!
To oh, no.
That was so close. That was razor thin. Is it 3 seconds?
It was like 3 seconds or something.
I think Boonie was like 1% away from Shatter there.
That was disastrous. But it is not all bad news for the Riders, as they have a whopping 3 minutes and 21 seconds compared to the Shapeshifter's measly 1 minute.
Yeah, If the Shapeshifters do pull out their special move again with the Bastion Lifeweaver Sim, I think the Riders should...
Surely not, yeah.
Just have an idea going into that, what they want to do, but... Wabakon onto the tour. I do like the tour.
There's that map you're talking about.
Yeah, Flawless does have a very good map.
Yeah.
They are running it with the Zarya. Which I don't think Zarya is the best to run the BAPs in with, but I genuinely think their goal might just be wait for Zynobaba to jump in on this Winston and then just burn him.
Yeah, I think that's the main plan with this. It's like Invictus is the bait, really. Invictus and
yeah,
Flawless.
Yep.
Even HV too, so. We'll have to see if they're
we
able to sustain.
Pretty much the exact same comp coming out from the Shapeshifters.
Yeah, Muffin Lumps tending towards that Lucio over the Zenyatta. unattacked though, notably.
This Torb also might be able to put pressure on the Tracer if she's trying to go in for deep flanks here.
Yeah, an early jump.
Oh, so low.
But this
Suzu's forced.
Suzu already. Yeah, Invictus knows Goku's there as well. Buni just takes
Zai
down.
A little bit too much poke coming in. Buni finds two.
Yeah, Buni finds Muffin as well as Zainubaba.
They're going to be able to touch here, but it's going to be really difficult to push into this setup the Riders have here.
Yeah, good disengage from the shapeshifters now, allowing Buni to just walk on them there, get the late staggers, as it looks like Goku will have the touch onto the point. A jump comes out from Zainubaba though as Goku tries to take down this turret. One melee Zainu's away. Zainubaba is so low. Of course, Pneumonia's TP and Suzu. A miracle needs to be made here as Flawless gets two.
They do have the Tracer that can stall it out, but I don't think it's gonna. Yeah, it's not gonna be enough here. Hey, you remember what I said going attack. Into this map about the first to three? Best of five, and I was like, maybe if it's a tie, it would be best of six.
Yeah, but I mean, Riders have three and a half minutes.
Yeah, they do have 3.5 minutes. Surely they are able to at least get one tick on the attack here.
Yeah. It is unlosable for the Broncos Country Riders,
it
which is
unlosable.
Very big. Call us the African artist because I'm ready to draw.
Is that, I don't know if that's a reference to something I am just completely missing.
It's like an artist like to draw.
Why is it, why are they African though?
I think that's just the first like A place that started with A that he could think of.
Asian, Antarctica. You can go after like specific countries like Angola,
good.
Austrian. What are they saying in chat?
You don't need to worry about right that. Now. Like Honkai Star Rail things, I think.
Yeah. Invictus is showing this Sombra. They might be playing to just build all their ultimates and just have one fight to win it. Which I think is really risky. Because then if you do that, you might allow some get some momentum coming on the defense. Goku on his classic Torb pick.
You know,
known for the Torb.
You know, the Torb extraordinaire in the league. As well as Slimo moving over to the Ash. And Zainubaba on his signature.
So low.
I am liking the Rhyne swap. That's like one of the main heroes to try and be able to beat up Buni, but Slimo's just distracted and unable to really run on anyone. Apparently Suzu is forced by Flawless just to keep himself up as Wabakon falls from the side of the Country Riders. It's just this whole map has just been Buni walking forward and just beaming down everyone on Zarya.
Buni walking. Oh, Zainubaba's back! Oh, he gets moved off. Unlucky. So yeah, after that very decisive first map, that was a pretty decisive second map too. So we'll see if momentum stays in the Broncos' favor.
Yeah. It is going to be Shapeshifter's map choice on this one.
I think Flash, or what is it called? Oh my god, I'm blanking. Blinked! Slimeball blinked into Buni, didn't even see him there, and blinked directly into the beam.
Yeah. That sounds about right, but...
So, well, we will see if any swaps come out here.
We will. I would not be surprised to see Rusty Goomba Peck come back in on the Shapeshifters. The main playmaker for that Busan map as well. On the Tickle Monster, the Doomfist. We will have to see.
I also think if they do try to commit to the Doomfist specifically, I think it is a little bit harder to run on payload maps than on cough maps.
Yeah.
So I don't know if they're going to stick with the Doomfist specifically, but...
We'll have to see. Nell Swaps coming out from the Broncos country writers is it will be Zainababa for Rusty Goomba yet again. As we expected. And it will be Route 66.
Yeah, that is one of the payload maps that I think Dive in general, and especially the Doomfist, might actually be good on.
Yeah, I remember a lot of people saying that this is like one of Invictus's playgrounds, really, on the Ash, because he just sort of sits on the high ground.
He just sits on high ground. There's so many high
grounds.
Especially
on, like, second point, it's so hard to dislodge them.
Yeah, it goes both ways, though. If Invictus has high ground control, it's really hard to dislodge him, but if you're able to control the high grounds away from Invictus, it's really hard for him to get set up.
Yeah.
So maybe that's part of the reason they picked this, is they wanted to try to just do high ground control and maybe have a Tracer just push the card, have everyone else just live on the high ground and keep Invictus from getting value up there.
Yeah. Really quick map break here, as we will be going straight into the next one.
And this also likely will be the last map I am able to cast, because I have to go make a scrim after this.
Oh, way, man.
I don't know if you have any sub set up.
I don't.
You want to tag out? Wait, did they have no swaps on either side? Oh, they haven't signed you out.
No, they have Rusty Goomba in for
the Broncos
Zainababa.
Are running with it? This looks like the best
team in the solar Broncos are just...
Wobbuffet going into the season? I had no expectations for him. He's actually been playing pretty well.
Wobcon?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He got a big special move. He got a lot of value on the Torb, actually. Just able to stay alive and get some poke.
Definitely. I believe coming in at, like, silver on the sheet on DPS.
At least when he signed up, I believe he was silver.
Yeah. It is mega value for the Broncos Country Riders. 1,800 flat.
Yep.
For them, which is really good.
We do see the Winston coming out. Booney, I would expect Booney actually might swap to the D.Va here. It's a little bit more value against the Winston and is able to control the high grounds a little bit more.
I can see it. I think he's just trying to ride the donk walking train.
Yeah.
Milk it for all it's got, really.
And Rusty Goomba's slow.
Where it's working. Rusty Goomba does not jump out in time as...
No, he's on the card.
Wobbuffet and Booney are just the hit squad that takes them down.
The W Warriors.
Press
W into their spawn.
There he is. HV the Reddit Lucio as well. Wobbuffet not make the same mistake Rusty Goomba does.
Booney is really out here, yeah. The problem with no one pushing the card is that no one was in a position to heal Booney there.
Yeah. Just clean up the shapeshifters. Invictus does. As Wobbuffet will fall temporarily here.
Invictus is half to his EMP. Oh, they do catch Wobbuffet out.
Yep.
It is me, the replacement caster.
Another one. Let's go.
I just realized I should have... Wait, I can just leave and respec.
Yeah. Yeah, just join up on me.
Oh yeah, Mom.
Booney gets taken down again!
Oh...
I think Booney could swap here. I think it would still work perfectly fine with the comp, and I think it would play a little bit better into the comp the shapeshifters are running.
Yeah, I have no idea why you would run Sombra's Azaria on this map specifically on attack. That seems kind of hard throw, to be honest.
Muffin's really low, which does stay up here. EMP is really close, but also a lot of ults coming out from the shapeshifters. It's going to be really tough to push into here.
Rusty gets the spy check as well, and
oh,
there's no translocator down,
the
so Invictus will die here most likely.
Surely he dies here.
He
does.
No, he missed him.
He put the schmooves on him. Booney is low. EMP is coming out. They might be able to engage off this EMP.
Suzu. The Ajax!
Ajax into the dragon. That's kind of crazy. Crazy?
Goku with 2,
Goku
get a 5k.
Nope.
Oh, steals it! No shot!
I could never hack. Hmm. Nice play from Goku, able to find 4 there as well as cancelling HP6 sound barrier. As you see him move over in shame onto the Ana.
Wobbuffet has a special move though, so it's over. Surely he's gonna get another 4K.
Kitsune Rush comes out as
Rusty Goombi is sleepy.
Wobbuffet!
Wobbuffet, no! Booty, no!
Riley, no!
Riley, no! Urakumi, no!
Who's next? With the left picks.
It's the
Who's next? Oh. Is Gugu next? No, the hack doesn't go off. Oh, but the...
What?
Bro, I'm saying, Kiri is broken.
Wait, Logan thought he was on the same
Kiri
side.
Kiri is literally better if you're off-rolling. I swear.
I they're playing, they're just clicking the heads.
Just Flawless don't play Kiri like a support. That character's 10 times better.
Yeah.
HP sleeps.
Goomba.
Rusty.
Oh, the dragon! Did he catch anyone? But the
special move.
Sitting on point from Logan.
Wobbuffet doesn't use the special move.
He does not. The TP is canceled. I saw that. I saw the animation get canceled from a third person POV. I saw the hands begin to clap, but they did not finish.
Oh, Invictus has point, has the EMP. He does get it off, but it's not going to matter.
To be honest, I did not like the Sombra at all. I think you should have just gone with Ash or Hanzo.
I think this is one of those scenarios where I don't think Invictus was doing bad on the Sombra per se, but I think you could.
I'm not saying he was doing bad on the Sombra. I'm saying the character is just not the right pick with the comp.
Into your team comp, yeah.
That's fair.
I think they would have. I think a Tracer would have been really good there.
I just think you put him on a Poke DPS rather than a dive DPS, and you stick with the Zarya.
Yeah, I could do that too.
Because
the problem is they keep like
you
half
almost
committing.
Yeah, but you did so well with the Zarya last map, and I think you just want to go back to that. Surely they pulled that out on the fence, but they're probably just gonna do. Yeah, Pocket Ash.
I personally really like Torb under 66, especially this first point.
It's good, but Ash is better, so that's why.
No, that's what I'm saying. I like that they're running both of them.
I mean, well, playing Torb on this map, it's like, yeah, Torb's good, but it's always outclassed, like how Torb is usually.
Yeah. Booney swaps over the D.Va, which I was hoping to see. Put a little bit more pressure under Rusty Goomba here. Rusty Goomba was consistently getting really low and just was not getting taken down. I think the D.Va's going to help put a little bit more damage on him. We do see Goku onto the Genji, which he is very good at.
No, honestly, he's kind of washed.
The Hog's DPS extraordinaire from last season. Slime Ball thinking about swapping, he has no clue what he wants to do. We'll have to see if the Pocket Invictus strat works here. As Goku decides to go straight in with Rusty Goomba as well. Wobbuffet gets a nice right click.
Okay, he gets two!
Goku and Rusty
He's
Goomba.
Cracked! He's insane! If they're able to, like, the problem with running the Ash is that if they're running dive, you are going to have to play around Invictus, like, make sure you keep him alive, and that's exactly what they did, and it worked out really well. So
yeah, I mean, this is a perfect setup, because Invictus can play at that single angle, you'll be able to shoot them if they dive in, you have a Torbjorn who can't really be though, the Torb then peels to the Ana. The Ana is also currently playing really far back, which is pretty good,
because
there's nothing to pressure that at all.
Force the
high ground, which is good. Chased by the Genji, he kited low ground instead. Of they're getting Coach Gun to get back to the other high ground, which is kind of unfortunate. As Booney is also dematted, it looks like this will be the end of this map.
Yep.
It's not looking very good.
HP does have Valkyrie, that might be able to give him enough time, but it is not looking good for the Riders here.
The Mercy Pocket onto the Ana, so the Ana literally cannot die.
and the Val.
And now the the anti, she's
the
killable.
Nano-Valk.
The Nano-Valk! Let's go!
HV finds
winnable?
One. Wait, HV finds two.
Winnable?
Oh my goodness, Mercy's broken.
You should not be allowed to run 3 DPS in Overwatch 2.
The fact that Flawless lives from Yellow Beam for that long because they didn't commit enough people onto him, and then he just can build Valk and then get Nano Valk. That's just Oh god. But look at the ults coming online with the shapeshifters.
Yeah. Is it time?
Is it Chill's counter one?
It's time.
There it is.
He finds one. Where did the Mercy go?
Wait, where'd the Mercy go?
Wait.
And he's
They do trade it.
For a trade.
In the back line.
The bomb? Wait, the bombs? Not getting big.
Wait, Demodia finds the support. Demodia finds both supports.
Hobocon gets his one. I don't think they're going to be able to do it here, yeah. Very chaotic fight. For a second, I thought the Broncos were going to be able to like save off all the ults that were being used, but it was simply just too much.
It's too much to handle as well, with Demonia taking down the support line, as well as getting two other final blows that fight.
Oh, oh my god.
HP has just juggled.
So, in the pause time, what do you guys think the next balance patch will entail?
I think Murphy's gonna get a buff. That's all I know. I think surely they're gonna nerf Junkrakmane. Surely.
I think there needs to be nerfs to JQ and Hanzo. Just because Hanzo's getting a hell of a lot of playtime in, I think, Contenders and Owl. So it would make sense for that character to be nerfed.
Yeah.
Plus a good amount of playtime as well in comp, I think.
I think they should buff Reinhardt.
I don't think so.
Because, I mean, I feel like there's no situation where... Like, I'm trying to think of, like, other tanks that are,
it's
like, other
JQ
characters
is
that are, like,
better,
bad.
That's why.
That's probably part of it, yeah.
Why run big shield man when you can run small buff woman?
The problem is, since Ramattra's been out, Ramattra's been just consistently better than Reinhardt. Just in any situation.
Oh yeah, you still need to nerf Ram, that's true.
So yeah, I guess you could nerf Ram or buff Ram.
Ram still I don't think you buff Ram, you nerf Ram, and then you need a Tracer still needs to be nerfed.
Tracer, yep.
Tracer and Sombra both need to be nerfed. Tracer needs like a half damage less. Or something like that.
Tracer needs the smallest change possible.
No, honestly, I think the character should stay where he is for all of existence.
Okay. If they go into this, I'm probably going to stop talking, because I'm probably going to leave soon, but I'm going to stay in here until I get summoned.
Mm.
So you are free to cast.
What do you think? What do you think, Riddle Dog?
What?
Balance changes. Oh, yeah, they need to nerf Widow as well.
You know the classic nerf Kenji, right?
Yeah, classic nerf Genji. Honestly, yeah, I could see. I think Genji still needs a deflect nerf.
You actually believe that, like, don't you?
Yeah, he needs like a half second off deflect. It lasts way too long, man.
Huh.
Give him his ammo back and take a half second off deflect.
Yeah.
I would die on that hill.
We will be going to Esperanza.
Esperanza?
Yup.
Welcome. So apparently there's
Winnie
a picture
did
of
call
Light
it
Weaver on this
Esperoinka.
Map.
Esperanza.
Esperanza? I hardly knew you.
Oz Martins.
Oh, there it is. I've never seen that before in my life.
Oz Martins?
I've never seen that portrait in-game. But, because didn't they say that was going to be the new character? That was the leak, at least?
I don't know. I remember seeing a thing which showed a painting in here, and it was actually... It contained a character that was, like, I don't know. It was like teased early days, like, you know, Mama Hong and that.
Mama Hong! I love Mama Hong.
You know, like all that group of people?
Yeah.
And that one of the characters there was actually in a painting here.
Nice. Anyways, Bastion. Back on ice. Bro, this is such a good Ash map.
Sombra.
I also really just do not like. I do not think there's any real coordination that to be had between Sombra and Zarya. Like, you can't dive in off a target, sacked. You can't do anything. HV is just kind of chilling here.
Oh, the
HV does get the slips. He does get the kill, but I think he will die for it because even with the TP back, this Suzu's slightly late, but I think it was off cooldown. Back there for Peel, it doesn't really matter. Rockupin is just zoning out Muffin as well. But you do have him, as the rest of the team does fall back, but Boone does not have enough energy to force it in. And once again, it's just a hack from behind. Does nothing really happens with it. As Boone falls again to him, pushing it into an easily May wall offable area. I think.
Logan's on
also, path. Look at Boone's ult charge.
36.
That's Zarya into Reinhardt a lot of the cases. Specifically, once again, you have a Reaper to bubble, but you have a Sombra and Reaper for shield break, so it's not the greatest.
Yeah.
I would really like to see some changes. Oh, that's a Rockabin going crazy, though. Flawless does fall to Logan. They should be able to eventually win this fight, able to get on the high ground to get Logan off, and you do get the fight win. But still, you have EMP coming in here, Nano EMP, or Nano just Reaper running at them. Going into... Yep. Okay, if you're smart, you want to try and save EMP for window to cancel out that ult if possible. But I don't know if that's necessary.
Does he know?
Slime walls. Yeah, you have Slime Wall also swapping off the Tracer off the Bastion. Dooku's still on the May. I would like also to see Boone swap onto... Okay, there's with the EMP.
Huge
EMP. No one set up to follow up, though. Rockman is there, bubbled up. Is Nano, gets the spin. Move. Able to clean him off. The pin is almost there, doesn't catch it. And it does look like it has to be another fight win. Three ults used, though.
Classic Wavacon W.
They will be able to get... They should be able to get the checkpoint, if not get for one fight to the checkpoint. They should definitely get the lead, though.
Yeah. Well, it's almost got that Kitsune Rush with Boone. Still building up to that grab.
Yeah. Oh, they got the Lucio speed back, though. I guess they won't get the lead. Speedy boys.
They're fast Muffin lumps on the Lucio.
They just get Goku. Well, okay. Look at this map. Look at HP just on the high ground. Oh, the shatter, though. The Suzu, it was a peel, but the pin is onto Boone. Might be fell, but does get the bubble up. And it does look like a Rakuten. Once again, we're picking him up, but the pulse onto... It's kind of fruitless, though. Resets the energy that Boone was trying to build, but a Rakuten... Rakuten. Uraka. My Uraka guy. Ooh-wah, ooh-wah, ooh-wah. Going crazy. Yo, I think HV needs to send over his Reaper mask to this man, because he's just the Reaper guy.
He should. That'd be crazy. Boone is back. He's got the grab, though, with...
Fight here. You don't really fight here. You just kite... Force him into this high ground. There you go. Well, yeah. You don't fight here, you don't fight the choke. And just play in the area where HV has the high ground control. Just perfect for this.
Oh, Goku decides to invest the...
I don't know if that's...
Though.
Yeah, it's another fruitless ult. Another fruitless snow ult on Boone.
it's smart with the riders just back up and, like you said, just fighting in this high ground so HV can just sit here with nothing happening to him.
Yeah. This is when you definitely want Slime ult to try and push that high ground. Zenobaba also swapping onto the Zarya. I would have liked to see Boone eventually swap to the Reinhardt, but, you know, unlucky. Didn't happen.
Yeah.
No Ryan duel to be had.
No honor.
Man, no honor.
They do have Nano Bapping. Oh, here we go. There comes
Kanani
the
is dead.
Cuckoo.
Once again.
Does
very good EMPs.
Too.
Able to get that window off, but it looks like this will eventually... Ah, another pulse. But he does get two, though. Those are pretty good staggers onto both supports. Dying. Ugh. Logan now also swapping onto carry off the Baptiste. He's had enough.
Invictus, no slime walls there.
It's
a hack.
Interesting fight that just occurred there. Oh, Slimo needs to get out of there. His entire squad rolling up on him. Does Invictus just even chase? Invictus just wants to. Vicky? What are you doing, buddy? He's chasing the Tracer. He wants to take that fight.
He's just running behind.
They didn't. Oh, they stopped pushing the payload for a split second, so they don't even get the checkpoint. That's really bad. They have that's no high ground control. They had no one to take high ground.
Oh, Goku's under.
They needed to fight high ground here.
Muffin Lumps gets hacked.
Oh, there's no cohesion as to where they want to play.
They're clueless.
Slimo does try and chase out Invictus, and Logan does get a single kunai to get that kill. But it doesn't really matter, because you still have Nano Blossom. As well as Kitsune coming up for you, Goku's finally on the high ground. It looks like that will be the kill that closes it. At least they did not use any ults. They didn't start with high ground this fight, but they eventually got it. But I think it was mostly poor positioning from the Riders, to be honest. I think they conceded that high ground way too easily and didn't try and commit to a fight up there.
They just all rotated around one another. Like, they're on, like, a carousel. The Riders were on the high ground, and then they all dropped, so the Shapeshifter just rotated around and took that. And with the Hanzo and Kiriko, they were just able to get so much done with that.
Invictus does get the solo kill onto Goku. Did not fully peak for supports. Pulse onto Buni. All that really does is give him a bunch of energy. Wraith is used from Urakupin. Might be looking to go in here. Doesn't have the ability to blossom, but does not look like as they are being kited. As you have Slimo on the point trying to fight Invictus, and Invictus does find him.
Yeah, only one ult used after that.
Dino Baba needs to just die here. You are not getting out. You have no energy. Zyno What's the
Baba.
Point?
Oh.
Nice catch, buddy.
No way, man.
Okay, ults. So many ults to use from both teams.
Let's go.
You grab Dragon? Okay, that's easy. You just grab Dragon this fight. You do have Suzu to deal with, but I don't think it really matters.
I mean,
you
just
should be
can't
able to get
kicked
enough.
Off again.
He has Kyrithm. He's fine. Yeah. Oh. And if it just dies, you still. I
just
think you can still.
Twice.
Oh, God. Oh, look where HV is. He's back.
He's on the high ground.
They do need to kite this. They should play secondary high ground and just wait for them to come in. You can honestly let them push all the way through to their checkpoint and just look for the fight from this high ground if they don't try and push you off.
HV
think they will.
So aggressive on this Ana. Gets Muffin purpled. But.
Oh, the spin does get Muffin Lumps. He just be felled. No grab dragon use. It's just a solo ult onto the Ana on high ground, but it does look like the headshot's coming in. Just clean them out. This is not how you wanted these fights to go if you're the Riders. It's still even a bit scrappy from the point of view that the Shapeshifters, but a fight win is a fight win.
HV has had this nano for so long. He just really needs to use it. I mean, they have the grab as well. Buni pushing super far forward.
Big HV. Okay, that should be easy cleanup from the nano. Buni needs to shoot someone that's not the Zarya, though. Big grab, does get three. Oh, the nade is blocked by Rockabit. No, just get the nade up to the team.
Pneumonia is so low. Simol is behind. But it's just clean up.
Another scrappy fight, but once again, a fight win is a fight win.
Uh-huh.
All ults used now. Flawless is coming out on his Kitsune Rush, and the response is only a pulse. And this is going to be really hard for the Shapeshifters to come out. They need to win this fight off the back of this pulse and build ults for their next two fights.
Yeah, they're still at the disadvantage here with that lead being
oh, the high ground
favor.
Too. They didn't get the checkpoint. That's unfortunate though. Looks they just kind of ults. They're just playing low ground.
Thymol's coming up behind.
Rockabin needs to help in HP keep this high ground as much as possible. You're just gonna concede it. High ground is now given to Slimol and to
Flawless.
But it doesn't seem to matter as those two are eliminated eventually. Slimol is late behind. This even worse. They used their pulse, didn't get anything with it, and they don't even have. They didn't build much ult charge either.
I mean, the only good thing, I guess, for the Riders. Well, not for the Riders, excuse me, for the Shapeshifters, is that the Riders didn't build any ults as well.
Muffin!
Muffin!
Death Magnet himself!
Oh. Wait.
Hanzo.
Wabakon, wait.
Yeah. Kiri.
Yeah.
They built the ults.
But the sleep and the nade. The aggressive Ana play. Honestly, I admire that type of Ana play style in that
sure,
last fight.
Style.
Just to get one. Yeah.
Yeah.
You got his.
Just ape mode, like gorilla go in.
I think you need three fight wins in a row here.
Yeah.
Three or four. You might get three to just to get close to the lead, and then you might need another to finally cap it. But you grab dragon. If you can win with that, you need to win with that probably, and then start building next.
Hack comes out on Zyne to Baba. Falls so low.
Oh, the grab is so low. The grab. Dragon is in, does get the Zarya, Reaper is should be felt as well, but Zyne to Baba is dead, he needs to be able to swap in, but just does find two. Falls finds another into Slime Ball. It does look like this will be the end of the push.
No, wait, Pneumonia. No. Finds one, Invictus, EMP. Though, is in.
Headshot. Cuckoo. Nade with Fountain Arrows. Still, C9.
Oh, cuckoo.
And headshot. Oh, this is so bad. They need to swap. They have Zyne to Baba coming back on ball.
It's just Goku at 60 health on point. Wabakon! Shoot him! Nice.
He's got the special move!
Suzu forced by Pneumonia.
Suzu booped away, but it might be able to find him as well. He just slowly shuffles his way over. Nano onto Flawless.
Ooh, that's gonna be it.
Slowly but surely, they're able to close it out.
Ooh. That was a lot more convincing as well than that last map. It was close nevertheless, but we'll have to see. This is gonna be the last map for one of these teams this season as well, as its first round. Elim. Yep.
Double Elim.
So we'll have to see who is able to do this. Let's see. Can I start a poll?
I got a thing for you to show stream.
Really?
Yeah, there you go.
That's going to be hard to show to them, so I'm not going to do it. It's going to like take work. You will see Zyne to Baba come back onto the bench with Rusty Gumma going back onto tank as well. Let's see if I can get a poll or a betting going on here. My mod view. I've never clicked on mod view. What is this?
And you know, mod view is pretty hype.
Predictions. Start prediction. Here we go. Will win.
Who will win in Overwatch?
Who will win the series? Shapeshifters? Or the Riders? How long should I give them?
A minute. Because
a minute?
Any...
It could be. I'll give them two. Is... How about that?
Sure, I suppose. Oasis.
The map will be Oasis as well.
Oh, yeah, another thing. They might buff Orisa. They might buff Orisa in some way and nerf her in another.
That could be quirky.
Because I think they might need to nerf her CC, but buff, like, something else. Like, I still think you can revert the amount of push from the javelin spin.
Yeah.
And then maybe lower the cooldown on something or up the damage rate on an ult. Because honestly, I think the nerfing of the push on the javelin spin is both a nerf and a buff.
What I'm gonna do?
Fedora, who should I choose to win? I don't know, man. It's Gator v Gator. Flip a coin.
I found out that I can just there's a button to just say, yeah, I'm gonna end it. I'm gonna close it. So I can do that on first point cap.
Nice.
Yep, so, because no one bet with 50 seconds left.
Yeah, that's usually how Aurora bets go, my dude.
I know.
No, you choose. You know, I'm just gonna say vote for my old good Cap. If you don't know who that is, then you don't get to my opinion.
Do you know what the, you know the channel point rewards?
Yeah.
There's one called A Fate Worse Than Death.
Oh yeah, I saw that.
Is that just for the gulag, I think? It has a police car.
Either that, or just being banned in chat.
I could just ban Teddy M.
I could ban Teddy M.
True.
How do I ban people? There's the timeouts. There we go.
You wanted it, man. You wanted a fate worse than death, and that's what you
honestly,
got.
Honestly, I think if you just change your Twitch name to be Teddy M or Build-A-Bear, it would be so much better than whoever the heck the flow is.
The flow one with a 3 instead of an E.
Yeah. It's kind of weird.
I was giving it to Vind.
No, that's fine. That's Vind. Oh, too bad. Time out for 14 days. Goodbye. They both are.
They
looks
are
like we're going into
going
Owasas. As Transflect and Flamby Jamby both still ride the bench.
Yep.
That's pretty hype.
Very, very sad.
I wish that could be me.
You want to ride the bench?
I want to be a lowest.
I mean, they're the riders, so it makes sense
play.
That they're
oh
riding
my.
The bench.
Holy smokes. That is so hype. Broncos country. That's right. How's the pred going? It says 0 for both. Let's go.
No one's voted. Don't worry, Invictus is still on Sombra.
I think they should allow the streamer to like put like a default like 100 or so into the pot so that even one person can win a bet. And then it'll cause mass channel play inflation, but I don't care.
Yeah.
Anyways, Zarya, still on Sombra. I think Sombra works a lot better at this point, even though they did win with it. I still think an Ashe on that high ground specifically could have been kind of crazy, you know?
Oh.
And never mind, go Ashe right now.
go Ashe.
Rusty Goomba has his work cut out for him. He's playing into the Ua, the Ua Reaper, the meat shots, as HP's just dead. That's just L. TBH.
Yep. The gorilla on a playstyle against the gorilla. Time to close.
They need to do something. They need to find something too. Yo, Derek, stop playing Overwatch. I'm just gonna DM say
no,
good choice.
No. Good choice. Take down Boonie as well.
They're spawn camping now.
They are kind of spawn camping with Goku almost having his all spawn.
D.Va, I like that swap. That's a very good swap. Able to punish the monkey a lot more. I do think they can't just rely on punishing, though. They need to have someone play. Have someone need to make a play somewhere, which I don't know where that can be. It's either Flawless needs to get a good off angle and get a pick, or Invictus needs to get a solo pick either.
Oh! Goku does not land the pulse bomb onto HVSec.
Flawless is being harassed. He's being harassed.
Yeah. The sleep comes out on the Rusty Goomba, though.
Oh, might be able to catch Muffin Lumps here.
Muffin
he
Lumps
is caught.
That was big. Rusty goes in
even
goes further.
In.
He's purpled.
He's purpled. Might be just looking to stall, because this fight... This point could be really stalled with the characters they have right now. They just gotta be able to stagger out. The investment
the Kitsune.
Of the Kitsune is actually could be really big here as Muffin Lumps just got back.
Muffin gets hacked.
But he is death magneted.
It is him, the death magnet.
Rusty Goomba is back at it again, able to jump onto the back line. Kitsune is invested. EMP is invested in the back as well.
Only
Kitsune. Rockabon, Urakabin, Urakahaka Waka.
HV! Muffin is back again.
Muffin, woo!
Third time's the charm. He gets hacked again, he dies. Only using the support ults there for the side of the Broncos Country Riders.
Okay, you want to get a very good ult rotation going, so you want to win this fight probably with EMP Blossom and keep bomb.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, if you can win this fight try, just based off a pick from Flawless, that would be very, very good. That's the most potential. Or Invictus gets
the
off-pick.
On the Goku.
Oh, but HP is felded.
Wallace
does get his pick, but it doesn't look like he may fall. He does fall to Logan on point, who's looking to cap. Do not let him cap.
Let him go.
He finds another. Come on, stop this man.
Wait. They had three ults and they used
none.
The TP on the mech is really good though. They do have EMP and Blossom still coming back. They just gotta make sure Boonie can stall on enough. He does have self-cell armor, so he's stalling pretty good. EMP onto something. Muffin is dead again. No, my Muffiny boy. Oh, but Invictus EMP'd and TP'd all the way back into spawn.
They didn't use any ults to stop them.
Logan's crazy hitting these shots on this Kiriko.
Honestly, I still think Kiri's a better character when you're off-rolling and not playing her like a support player would.
That's fair.
Unless your team needs heals, then yeah, you should probably play like a support player, but I think more of her value comes from her damage.
Yeah.
And the pick potential.
The cardboard Reinhardt.
What? I can't believe he has that, but not the base department.
This is before he knew about the Bing rewards. The base department.
Bro, that mask, yo, the profile picture in the bottom left for the Reinhardt skin goes crazy, to be honest.
It does. Bobacon on the moving over to the Bastion from the Reaper guy as Invictus goes to the
Rhine duel.
Let's go, Boonie.
The Rhine duel.
The Glunku.
Except one of these teams has a main, one of them doesn't, so you would think
but the other has a one-shot Hanzo. Correct.
Yeah, that is true.
So.
Okay, but look at this angle that Slimeball has. This is a dangerous angle for him to have. It doesn't matter because the HV is now a death magnet.
Yeah. Slime comes out from
Flawless. On the Brap Tease, though. The trap. Guys, there's a Hanzo behind you. I think they were just far too slow. They're playing a rush comp and didn't rush in.
Yeah.
I think I see a small Baptiste diff in the ult charge.
Logan, step it up.
Logan, how about you actually play supports and not just a DPS? How about that?
Oh my gosh,
hello?
Riley's going.
Hello?
Lawless finds a
blood
group.
Hello?
Shatter comes out in the HV.
Hello? What's cooking?
What's that?
The death magnet strikes again.
Flawless realized he actually has to heal his team. So
you know,
DPSing.
That is what I wish I did not need to do as a Baptiste. Riley went in. He gets
just walked through the window.
Riley, Rusty Goomba, establishing the U.S. made cardboard is the differential.
Boonie does have the Reinhardt Shatter though. As Invictus goes over to the Sombra. Again, Cuckoo! Wobbegon! The Lamp.
Rusty Boonie. Is in there. Rusty needs to die. Rusty Goomba needs to die.
Rusty Goomba didn't die. It is not. A
I Muffin.
Dies
he, it was not a Ghostbuster. He got Muffin.
Yeah. Not able to Ajax him.
Kill Rusty Goomba!
Thank you.
Yeah, I feel like Operation Kill Rusty Goomba has not been successful.
It hasn't.
HV.
And because of that, I don't think Boonie's allowed to play as aggressively as he wants.
Yeah.
I see a small Baptiste differential. Flawless, oh. Step it up. maybe you should start healing more.
Igon achieve. They have the Hanzo and the Baptiste Igon. Riley is in. He should suffer from this. But they're so split from his Baptiste. Oh,
wait,
the kill feed.
Muffin.
Muffin lumps. What are you cooking?
He
saved
up.
Himself.
Wait, he also Goku? Saved Goku. Save the Glunker.
Wait, Muffin going. You win these.
Wobbuffet is going to be coming back late, but...
EMP Blossom, please, you can do it. I believe in
Wobbuffet's
you.
Wobbuffet's not
EMP
back.
EMP Blossom, the backline.
He's not back yet. The window was cancelled immediately. Invictus.
Try another window not be canceled by EMP Challenger.
Hanzo! Woo! Uh-oh.
Oh, Flawless.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Whoa. The tire from spawn. Actually, that's just a movie.
Goodbye. Okay, decent stall, though. All that fire strike just clips the toes of Invictus.
Wobbuffet! Wobbuffet!
That was pretty hype, to be honest. I think that was pretty hype, to be honest. That's a pretty good pick. But he needs to touch, but he's a touch through dragon, gets pushed into them,
ooh,
and just felled.
HV.
Boss coming back on the nails. Might be able to catch Muffin. Muffin is dangerously low, dies to the suck. But Floss does catch a fire strike for his troubles. That's not very, very epic. Rockabin is back.
He's just trying to get this. Oh, he can't get it.
Boonie comes back with Shatter release soon. They need to get a secondary touch. Boonie is there. He has a Shatter. He finds a shield. He is felled in. Looks like that will be GG's in favor of the shapeshifters and the good old cap that I don't think Teddy ever betted on.
No one bet anything, man.
What the heck? Where's my gamblers, man?
No one wants to gamble.
Smart, to be honest.
Yeah. That was a crazy series. The Broncos, I think, putting up more of a fight than many people expected as well.
Yeah.
Which is good for them. Sadly, it is the end of the season, though. The end of their
run. That means the death of their team chat as well.
Yep.
It shall be felded.
It will. So you were watching the whole series?
I had it on the entire time, but did I pay attention? Eh.
I think I have an idea for the MVP.
I mean, my observation is that Muffin Lumps died.
That is a correct and good observation.
Yeah. I bet Rusty Boomba is pretty good because he probably shoutcasts his calls.
Probably.
Which probably helps with coordination.
Yeah. But I'm thinking of giving it to Mr. Pneumonia.
Holy smokes, the Gator guy? I don't know, man.
Able to.
I don't know.
Find as many picks diffed. As he did.
He did get diffed that one instance when I checked the Baptiste ult charge.
He did. He did. So it's kind of tough to give it to him, but I think that we're going to have to give it to him.
All right,
pick
where
him our
is
MVP.
He?
I'm stealing him.
Oh, I was going to steal him.
Already stole him.
So, Logan, I got the first question for you. On that last point of Oasis, why were you 20% ult charge behind Flawless on Baptiste?
Because he's the GOAT.
Okay, good answer, good answer. Gator gain. Anyways.
Congrats on moving forward in the bracket. Thanks, man. And defeating the Broncos Country Riders.
Yippee. I love Aurora Esports Overwatch Clash.
So what were you expecting to happen going into this match, you think?
I was expecting a lot more Junker Queen from both sides. Well, I don't know about Boonie, but especially us. And it felt really refreshing not hearing Hung and Wah. And...
No dongs. There's no dong, by the
and
way.
What do you mean no dongs? There's never a dong.
I know, that's what I'm saying, is that it is not a dong. So
yeah, I'm a hashtag dong denier.
Let's go.
You hear that, MJ? You're schizophrenic anyway.
It's fine, he is.
What's going on in here? How are you guys doing?
Good.
I came in here to fill in Panini's shoes after he left to go scrim.
I see.
Yep.
First time casting in a while.
It was good. Yeah.
Well, yeah, we gave you a 5-map slammer for it.
Oh yeah, yeah, Mario.
You're able to. You got a lot of picks on Kiriko. It seemed like you're getting headshots like every other fight.
Yeah, I was just kind of, they were like, all their heads were like together, and I was just throwing them in the middle of them, and sometimes they would hit.
I said this a few times during the cast, but I think Kiriko is a better character when you're not a support player.
Yep.
Because the more you tunnel vision on supporting, the worse the character is.
When you're a Genji Hanzo player, it turns out the wall climbing, fast moving projectile character is not that new to you. Or what? Yeah. Not that new.
Oh yeah, Mario. Yeah,
so, let's see. You don't know who your next opponent is going to be because they have to choose you.
Who do you want your next opponent selected to be, buddy?
Who do you want it to be, though?
Who can pick me?
The pandas, the Nessies, the mice, and the Team 2 Tortuga guys.
I think I want a TT2 rematch.
Mm.
That's
and
because
I don't want to play the red pandas again.
Is that the
Nessies?
Who do you want to least play against least?
You.
Oh, okay, fair.
You had too many good players on your team. It's hard. I gotta think. Everybody's gotta think more than play. And when you gotta think more than play, sometimes you don't play good. So,
why do you want to face Tortuga? What do you think?
Because I think it was really, really winnable last time we played them, and it was really close. And I want to give it another go.
That's fair.
Holy smokes! A Bramble Gas just spawned.
Holy.
Wow.
Is it infiltrator?
I know you're a Bap hater. Why'd you switch to Bap?
Because I was, you know, I just played it for the comp. And I think I did okay. I just shot more, and it felt easier. And when we were doing aim 1v1 lobbies before, my BAP aim felt crazy. I went on like a 10 streak on BAP or some shit in mid, so I was like, yeah, I'll pick it. Why not?
That's fair.
And then on Esperanza, like the first part of Esperanza was like fine, because there was no crazy angles to, but like as soon as it started getting onto the sides closer to spawns, there's all those other angles, it was making me schizo, and I wanted to be on the schizo character for the schizo part, so I swapped.
That's fair.
Crazy? I was crazy once.
I didn't even say crazy.
A rubber rim.
You did.
A rubber rim with rats.
Did I?
Yeah.
Crazy. Crazy? I was crazy once.
I said schizo.
Same difference.
Okay.
Broncos Sorry. Country may be over, but Boonie would always ride with his boys.
Let's ride.
Can we get a Broncos Country Let's Ride in the chat?
Yeah. Whether it be Gen Let's chat or this chat.
Ride. Fuck it, I'll do this
Come
one
on,
too.
Come on, chatting chatters.
No, oh, I'm allowed to cuss on this one. Let's Bronco. Ride. Wait, there's a GIF for it. I don't have to type it. Broncos.
So, do you have any more questions? Or should we ask?
If you were not the MVP, wow. Who on your team MVP?
I think Chummy Lumps.
The Death Magnet himself?
The Death Magnet himself.
Yeah.
Wait, guys, I have a big revelation. Teddy changed his Twitch name to Build-A-Bear.
You see, it's Build-A-Bear. Build-Double-A-Bear.
Double-A-Bear? Holy smokes, it takes batteries?
Should call him Double-A.
Batteries not included. There's definitely no batteries included with Teddy. What do you mean?
So you said Chummy?
Can't get the original one, man.
Chummy wasn't there. Muffin was.
Yeah, Muffin.
I said Chummy Lumps because I don't remember.
Why Muffin? Why Chummy Lumps?
He took the death so everyone Muffin else Wummy. Could live. Nah. He took the death so everyone else could live.
Nathan's got a point.
Bro, Muffin would go crazy in MMOs. He just gets aggro.
Holy, yeah, wait. This guy... Go play WoW. Go be an arms warrior or whatever the tank one is. I think Pally's ass. I could ask Sith Base Muffins. Base Muffins. Oh, he went to bed. GG.
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 So. Thanks for joining us and congrats on the win again.
hopes, man.
Hope to see you do well in the next round as well and move on.
I was going to say YouTube, but I'm pretty sure you have a bye.
So. I do have a bye. I haven't played in 2 weeks.
Good.
It's not.
Praying on your downfall right now.
It's fine. We already scrimmed and we're planning another.
Imagine scrimming.
Yeah, imagine scrimming.
Imagine not being on like 3 scrim teams and scrimming.
And none of them play.
I mean, I'm just saying, I'm for the Blight Vitriol or whatever it is, I'm waiting for this meta to be over.
Blight Montreal, yeah, we can wait till Queen Nerf, honestly.
That's what Blight Rip Biohazard is that you're waiting for.
That's, yeah, this map is that this series is actually really refreshing not seeing a queen. So thank you to both tanks.
Don't worry, I'm forcing JQ for the Overwatch team, I think.
Uh oh.
Just
play Doom.
Doom?
Yeah. MF Doom. Holy.
Duck Fetty.
Alright. I think that should do it for us on the cast here.
Okay.
Alright. Bye, Logan.
Okay. Bye bye. Good night, everybody.
This has been Riddle Dog signing up for Fedora Master as well as Panini an hour ago. Goodbye, chat.
Bye.
Bye, chats. Bye-bye.